What's going on, guys? Welcome back to episode 2 of Elite Shreds season 2. Weighed in at 197.5 pounds today, but let me tell you, it has not been an easy week of weigh-ins. I've been 199. I've actually gone up over 199, 198.5. What I did, because my weight had stayed roughly around 199 for about 4 or 5 days, like I said in my last video, I actually dropped my calories. If your weigh-ins have been the same for like a week or around a week, that's when you should drop your calories, like I said. So I dropped by 100 calories, continued with my standard cardio, 3 times a week, 300 calories. Lo and behold, I woke up to a new low weigh-in this morning of 197.5. So happy out with that. Very excited to see where this goes. I've figured that once I get down to about low 190s to high 180s, I will be fairly damn lean, and I can't wait to show you guys. Welcome back to Elite Shreds season 2. Sliced my finger open with a bread knife. Wasn't a nice feeling, would not recommend. So today I'm going to talk to you about citrulline malate, which is a supplement that I use a lot and I would definitely recommend. Any supplement you want, there's a link in the description. You can get 20% off with my code. But today I'm going to talk about citrulline malate, what it is, what it can do for you, and does it actually work, is it worth it, etc, etc. So I'm going to go through it real quick, won't bore you guys, just going to give you guys the details you need to know to decide whether or not you're going to use this supplement. So, L-citrulline is a non-essential amino acid. It's found in the urea cycle, increases blood flow, reduces high blood pressure. There have been double-blind clinical trials done that have shown that it reduces fatigue, actually increases endurance in aerobic and anaerobic exercise. As a weightlifter, as a bodybuilder, increased endurance and reduced fatigue will lead to the ability to increase the volume of my training, which is key as a bodybuilder. Volume is key. Now, a lot of people might know L-citrulline from seeing it on the back of pre-workout tubs as an ingredient. The fact of the matter is, there's never enough in these pre-workout supplements. In fact, you have to take 1.7 to 1.8 grams of citrulline malate for every 1 gram of L-citrulline. For the benefits that we want to reap from this supplement, we would have to take between 6 and 8 grams of L-citrulline. So that is anywhere from 9 grams of citrulline malate plus. So when you see L-citrulline or citrulline malate in these pre-workout supplements, you're not getting anything from them because they're underdosed severely. It doesn't have any stimulatory effect. It's not like caffeine, but it is used in a pre-workout because it is absorbed pretty quickly. I just like to supplement with it the same time every day. The same thing I do with creatine. I just put it in my pre-workout shake. So when I take mine, I take 3 scoops in my pre-workout shake, so that's 9 grams of citrulline malate. So that seems to be pretty much enough to reap the benefits of the supplement. And I would definitely recommend this to anybody who's serious about their bodybuilding, about their lifting. I have noticed an increase in endurance in the gym. I seem to be able to go for a little bit longer. I seem to be able to add in exercises here and there because of it. So I'll continue to use this. A lot of people have been asking about it, so I said I'd just say a few words about it. I will link some studies below that will support these claims that have done single blind, double blind tests, clinical trials. Grab yourself a bag of citrulline malate, use my discount code. That is that. I'm gonna continue with my day. I'm going to show you guys my workout today. I'm gonna be doing shoulders just for a change. I normally do shoulders on my push day, but I'm gonna give my chest a rest today. Have a little bit of a tight left pec, as you guys probably saw from my Instagram post. So I'm gonna focus on shoulders and triceps and get a good pump, get my citrulline malate in, and I will catch you in the next clip. Oh fuck, it wasn't recording. Too loud. Still too loud. Okay. Sounded good. All that with a plaster on my finger. Whoa, that peaked though. Thank you. So that is today's lunch, pretty big meal. Let me tell you how many calories. 520 calories, and I feel like I've just eaten 1,000. There's 200 grams of chicken, 130 grams of couscous, which you can get in Aldi, highly recommend that. And then I had carrot and parsnip mix, just mashed, boiled. That's gonna keep me full for quite a while. It's currently 5 to 4, I'm gonna train probably about 6 p.m. So it's time to mix up what I'm bringing to the gym. First off, citrulline mallet, like I was talking to you guys about earlier. 3 scoops of that. Gonna mix in my 5 grams of creatine. Remember, 5 grams a day is all you need. No need to load, nothing. Just gonna mix that into the shaker here. Drink that. Then I'm gonna bring some BCAAs to the gym. 1 scoop of that is 10 grams, so that'll be 10 grams of BCAAs. Just keep me going through the workout. And they taste really good as well. I think that is mixed berry. Yeah, it's probably my favorite one. Go to the gym, hit up some cardio, and push.
The song that you heard me editing earlier, the song that I just started making the other day. I've been making songs, I've been making music in some shape or form for the last like 10 years. Whether it's acoustic songs, in a band, in another band, and I was in a couple of bands, and I started producing music on my own in my room about 5 years ago. And this is the first song that I really think is gonna, it's a game changer. I can't believe it. I'm so psyched for this song. I just know it's gonna be something on another level. And just for reference, I've never thought about a song that I've made or am making in this way, and I have 3 songs currently online that have over 1 million views. That's not bragging, that's just to say I didn't think that those songs were gonna be big, and I think this song that I'm currently making is gonna be something special. So I just can't wait to get it done and to just finish this project. I'm so excited for some. It's gonna be big, I'm just so pumped. But anyway, that is completely besides the point. I'm about to hit a workout. Catch you in the gym.
Check this out, I got calves.
Yeah.
Never had calves before. Going to Nando's. I'm not one of those people who like hypes or overhypes Nando's. It's okay. It's overpriced, in my opinion. But I've got a coupon. I got a coupon for 2 meals because I won a quiz. So we're gonna use that. Normally get just the butterfly chicken and 2 sides. And it's actually pretty good macros, to be fair. So if there's anywhere you can go when you're on like a prep or dieting, this is one of the few places where you can probably still fit it in and be like happy enough, and with the accuracy of the tracking. All the measurements are on MyFitnessPal, so happy days. So that's where we're going, post-workout meal, Nando's.
Hello.
Check out the aesthetics. It is freezing! Welcome to the life of Instagram. Sitting in a car posting Instagram photos that we took in the gym today. Go follow this guy, I'll put his name on his face or something.
My face looks fat.
He's dieting for his show, so go support him on his Instagram. I'm dieting for myself. So go support me on my Instagram. Yeah, so this is the end of the vlog. Hope you enjoyed it. Season 2 of blah, 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 blah. Elite Shreds, Season 2, Episode 2. Over and out. Hope you enjoyed.
Peace.
Peace.